Welcome back to another episode of our message recap, the show where we recap messages. And this was the third week, 3 weeks deep into a series called Make Christianity Great Again. first couple weeks, we talked about salvation. Mm-hmm. We talked about spending time with God. And then this week, you kind of said that that's the base of Christianity. And this week was all about a life change.
Yeah. The result of kind of the first 2 weeks was this week's topic, this week's version. And I think probably in Christianity, I think what we talked about on Sunday has the potential to be one of the most misunderstood aspects of what it means to be a Christian, what it means to be connected to God. We end up using this idea of life change as like a way to poorly measure people's spiritual growth or where they're at, you know, by like, unfortunately, not only do we, it's not even a correct measurement, but we measure using the wrong forms of life change, you know, what words you say or how you act, which hopefully I covered pretty well. Like, that's not what I'm talking about when I mean life change, but this idea of being different, we've really screwed up.
Well, I like how you pointed out, you said in there, like, if we don't look at salvation and spending time with God, if we don't establish that as the base of Christianity, we just find ourselves in another religion. We're just going about, you know, like, I got to do this, I got to do that. And
if you skip those and just go straight to life change.
Yeah. It becomes all performance.
Yeah, go pick some other religion.
Yep. Yeah.
I think along the lines of what you were saying, too many churches, too much Christianity, we've all been taught certain things with this, even subconsciously, this idea that we measure how close we are to God by life change. I think it's even a step worse than that. I think the life change we perceive as being the way to God. That I get to God by life change.
Yep.
The more life change I have, the closer I'm getting to God. And there's this line that certain amount of life change I'm in, not enough life change I'm out.
Don't know where that is.
Kind of a thing. And nobody can tell you where that is. There's a lot of Bible verses that would support that if you didn't look at the whole context and the whole idea of it. And so that's why it was so important to establish Christianity is all about Jesus making us right with God. Why? So we could know him. We could be with him, have a relationship with him. The relationship with him produces, and that's where Sunday came in.
Yeah.
Only with God produces that. And I was just so happy with it. I just wish everybody would listen to it and watch it again and again and again and again. If there's anything, you know, we've talked about this for years, that this is Christianity. This series, I wish everybody would memorize and know and get this. This is Christianity. This life change can be huge, from little things to the rest of our life being more and more like God. But I loved in the message, and if you haven't watched it, you're going to in a minute, I love and watch for this part when he says, you know, we try to be patient. We try to be loving. We try. And here's the point. And again, we've, you know, just this is what it's about. I don't care how hard you try, how much you grit your teeth, how, you know, you are going to fail. And a great thing, and as you were talking, you know, I'm like, oh, I wish he'd say this, I wish he'd say that. But I just thought it's so perfect that we think we're doing good until we're squeezed, you know, until
you,
you said that everybody does, you know, good when everybody likes and when everything, but when things go wrong, then how well did you do? Really, how much life change did you produce? Because when we're squeezed, when everything goes wrong, when people treat us right, that's the litmus test. That right there, we can say, okay, so where is that fruit in your life? Guess what? It's really not there.
Right.
Because to get through it when you're squeezed only comes from God. And this message is the message of Christian life. We spend time with God and he transforms our mind, renews our mind. He transforms our character, who we are. And I really believe, which you established so well, we are like the people we hang around with. The more we hang around with God, the more godly we are. Period, end of story. You do it on your own, you know, vine and the branches. try to do it on your own. Jesus said it, and he's a pretty smart guy. Apart from me, you can do nothing. You're just not gonna.
And we've all tried.
Yeah, and
we've all tried.
You know, it ain't gonna work. It's not going to work.
There's something about, like, you know, at Christian pressure, or just life change in general. Not even from the, but we always want to fix the outside.
Yep.
The outside. You know, hey, okay, well, I'm gonna make, in the case of patience, which we talked about in the message, I'm just gonna make myself be more patient with you know, my spouse who didn't do something, like. Okay, so I'm going to fix how it looks on the outside,
yeah,
but do absolutely nothing about the white hot rage on the inside, because yeah. It's the fourth time I told you, remember to pin, like, oh boy. So that's where spending time with God is the only thing that can change the inside. Mm-hmm. You know?
So this goes, wraps around circle to a few weeks ago, we talked about just being authentic, different series, but... Mm-hmm. This comes back to being authentic. And when we try to do things on the outside, when we force ourselves to act a certain way, the biggest danger is we fool ourselves. There's been no change, no character change, no heart change, no value change. But because we act, we can control our actions when things are good, we start fooling ourselves and thinking that we're better than we are. Mm. And we're not. When it's tested, when we get squeezed, boom, there you are, right back. Guess what? There was no change.
Right. And the other thing about the patience one, where you went through the whole, okay, let's do a whole day and see how we do. Mm-hmm. You could, all right, you've got a whole list of those attributes that we want to be, mm-hmm. and then the list that we don't want to be. Mm-hmm. So even if you work on one of them, how many of the other ones did you screw up?
Can you possibly do?
You know, I could be patient, but I'm going to need a drink. Mm-hmm. There's no self-control. There's no self-control out the window. You've already lost it. Yeah. You know, like, you could try as hard as you want on one of them, but you're going to fail at the other ones. Then you're gonna drop the ball. It's kind of like the Ten Commandments as well. You know that deal.
Yeah,
where you can work on one of them, but how many of the other ones did you not make?
And you won't even make the one you're working on.
No.
And this doesn't mean like give up or don't care about representing God's character or having life change. It's just how we get it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Living a certain way doesn't approve us to God. Mm-hmm. And we are approved by Jesus, period. Mm-hmm. And by spending time with God, his character transforms who we are. Mm-hmm. And then that produces life change. This is Christianity. This is what it's about. And,
yeah.
You know, this whole idea of
just on that,
what we've turned it into.
Just on that point of we are approved by... I think, too, there's this idea out there that I wish I could punch somebody in the face, whoever came up with this, you know, full of the Spirit.
In love.
In love. But whoever said that, like, okay, once you put your faith in Jesus, then you have to, like, keep yourself approved. Or you have to, like... maintain your salvation somehow with your lifestyle and the way you live. Like
that has to be,
if I was powerless
to
get it in the first place, what makes you think I'm gonna keep it?
That has to be, I mean, possibly the biggest misconception when it comes to Christianity, right? Because of that, that's where we miss the whole spend time with God. We don't even have time to think about spending time with God.
No, because I'm too busy behaving.
Because we're so worried about how we're behaving. You know, I don't want to lose my salvation.
Yeah, Jesus made us right, and I got to do my best to keep us right, you know?
I think that's why we've started saying it more and more, and I just want to say it all the time, and that is that we were saved to enjoy God. Why don't we enjoy him more? and I even think this idea of enjoy him, we still too oftentimes go to him. You know, we gotta butter him up before we talk to him. We gotta go to him with, what about enjoy? He just wants to be with us. Why don't we enjoy him? Why don't we take this religious thing out of it and just enjoy God? Enjoy him.
Yeah.
Not work for him, not perform for him, not do somersaults for him, not to say, hey, look at the talents I have to entertain you.
Because it's been so skewed.
It is. That's terrible.
That's right. We talked about it the very, you know, just highly coupling. Look, we can read the Bible this way as like, okay, I got to read seven, or we can read it like the words of a loving father to us. We can talk to God with a grocery list, or we can talk to him for like all these different things. And Actually, just in small group yesterday, we were talking about this idea of like just spending, you know, my girls come up to me at night. They want to tell me about their day. Like, I don't care if they like get the story right or if they doze off while they're telling me, like, I just want to spend like, it doesn't have to be perfect. We don't have to say the right words. We don't have to be in the right setting. Like just that enjoying the relationship part. Mm-hmm. And why can't we get that right with God? Why? Mm-hmm. Like,
because it's been so skewed.
Let's make Christianity great again.
Yeah, no kidding. Well, I don't. And that's like, I love you guys have mentioned before how when people are talking about salvation and they're talking about Christianity, it's you say it's the end that like kills it when you're like, oh, are you know, are you going to heaven? And they'll say, well, yeah. And you're like, well, why? Well, because, you know, I accepted Jesus and. Well, no, that's it. Like, you know what I mean? That's it. And accepting Jesus allows us to spend time with God, and that's the whole point. And that
produces life.
I just want to address the crowd, people listening, if you've been there or you're still there, this idea, well, come on, that's cheap grace. You know, you can't just believe in Jesus and live however you want. I just want you to think about it from this perspective. When you stand before the judgment seat of God, and all your sin is shown there, and then your name is in the book of life. You know, if God were to ask you, which he won't, but if he were to ask you, why should I let you in? Imagine saying, with Jesus standing there, with the lamb that was slain, right? Jesus standing there. Imagine saying,
holes.
Imagine saying to God with Jesus standing there, well, I put my faith in what Jesus did, and what? Jesus is going to look at you and go, what? If my sacrifice wasn't sufficient, you have no part of me.
Yeah.
I'm not sharing my work with you.
Right.
You know, this is, salvation isn't multiple. It's one thing. It's Jesus, period. And listen, and I know there's a whole bunch of verses that say, well, this would produce, or if you're a Christian, you do this, or sacrifice this, or whatever. I get all that. But I believe if we had enough time,
as we a result of spending everybody. Time with God because of what Jesus did.
You are not going to stand before Jesus himself and say, you got me halfway.
You got me there.
I finished it. You really gave me a good start. And with your help, I mean, it was really great. You helped me, but I did something too. Yeah. Is not going to fly.
No.
Well, and I think that's the big thing that people come back with is, well, you can't, I mean, you're telling me I can just believe in Jesus and then do whatever I want, blah, blah, blah. Well, yes.
The Apostle Paul said, yes, you could.
If you read
Romans. No, he said you'd be dumb.
But here's the thing. This is what we talked about this week was, I've said it before, I personally don't believe you're going to go live a life of recklessness after accepting Jesus, because spending time with God will produce a life change. Does it have to for you to be saved? No.
Does it have to go in a certain order?
No.
Does it have to
do the top 10 first within the first year? Right. No.
And I think that's the hard thing for people to understand is, well, there's got to be like some repercussion or this or that. And it's like, just spend time with God. Just, you know, accept the gift that was given to you through salvation and your heart will change.
It will. And I think that's where James is coming from when he's writing. You know, and a lot of people think he opposes Paul. He doesn't at all. You know, when he says, show me your faith by your works, you know, and I think that basically that's what you're saying is, I believe this, if somebody puts their complete trust in Jesus to enjoy God and they start that relationship with God, you can't have a relationship with God without life change. You can't. It's impossible. Now, I don't know if it's going to be, you know, number 7 on the list, number 1, number 27, but there will be life change. It's impossible to not have life change mm-hmm. when you're spending time with the living God. Mm-hmm. Impossible. Mm. Now, I don't know what that's going to look like for each one of us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But try it out.
Yeah.
Well, that's why we talk about spending time with God so much, so mm-hmm. often.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Christianity. Mm-hmm. Making it great again. Mm-hmm. But this week was, it's a life change. It's going to mm-hmm. pop up here in a second. If you haven't watched it, I don't know why you're watching this, but click on it and watch that. And we'll be back next week. Just make sure to like, subscribe, do all that YouTube stuff, and see you next week with another message recap.
Yep.